Alright, welcome back, and this should be part 11 of our playthrough of Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. We just beat Sentinels in Las Bastilles. We are back in town, where I will level up before we continue. So I think we want to put a couple into Vit, and then just try and get our strength to 28. I think that was what we wanted to get to. Intelligence. We're not going to touch intelligence too much. Maybe get our vigor up. And then we will go see. Hopefully we can equip and start using a great sword. Yes, yes we can. That would, however, put our equip load up way too high, so we'll have to work on that. We should, however, be able to start wearing the full Drang Lake set, minus the helmet, which we do not have yet. Where are you? Can we use the Drang Lake sword, actually? We don't have the dex requirement for it yet. Alright, well, I think what we'll do is start by going back to Las Bastilles and just wrap up where we were. So we were in the servant quarters when we left off. Clear out the area, find all the rest of the secrets, and then keep progressing through the game. Down here is an optional area, which we will be doing. It does actually help quite a lot with the boss in Sinner's Rise area. Oh, and here's the Pursuer. We're just going to avoid him as a general rule. He's just annoying, and like I said, you don't get another boss soul from killing him, so there's not too much of a point. That should be him gone. You can fight him, it's souls, but it's, I don't know, he was just a pain enough the first time around. I don't think I want to fight him again and again and again and again. Him reappearing like that is something they added in Scholar's First Sin. In the original version of Dark Souls 2, he appears a total of 3 times, unless you want to count the optional boss area, so 4 times. We will need another Ferris Lock Stone to open this optional area. We don't have one just yet, so we will continue on our merry way. I never actually noticed that before, and I've played through this game a bazillion times. I'm gonna go ahead and just kill this butterfly. Radiant Life Gem. I literally had never noticed that before, and like I said, I've played through this game way too many times. You want to run down here, open this door, walk across, come back, close this door to get the item that's hidden over here, another soul item. Might actually have enough soul items to get another level. Run down to the end here at the U, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, there is another item. Bastille Key. Okay, I'm not sure where you came from. Also, not sure what the hell the Bastille Key does. That might be the key we need for the next boss. If that's the case, we are about to go do an optional area for no real reason. But hey, I did say this was going to be as close to 100% walkthrough as possible. And we're gonna stay with that. Not quite sure what that was. But something seems to be upset. Want to walk down here, across here. There's an item over here. Flame Butterfly. Flame Butterfly is basically just fire in a jar. You can use it to light a torch, even if there's no fire around. Run and jump across to get this item, another soul item. Down there is the area that we opened up with the key. that courtyard with the dogs and everything that I showed you guys. You can come up here, drop down, turn around to kill this fool. Here is another one over here. And a swordsman over here. Which, if we had just come up the stairs when we got to that tower, would have led to right in here. We went about it a bit of a different way, but it comes out to the same. This, if I'm not mistaken, is a completely useless door. Hey, look at that. There's a skull in the wall. You want to come over here, open this, and then get ready to fight a bunch of the exploding zombie mummy guys. Well, there you go. I was trying to hit him through the bars, but that's what happens when they actually get their exploding attack off. You saw that. It's cheap, it's an area of effect, and you end up taking a lot of damage. Let's come through here, and you should recognize this is going to bring us back to the area where we were when we shortcutted the whole thing. Up here is a barrel. If you knock it down, you should be able to knock it down. It will blow up. So again, you should remember this area. This is where we took the elevator up past that item. Again, be careful, exploding barrel. Somehow managed to not get that to explode. Like I said, I might come back and get that item, but it's really not worth it if memory serves. Just so you guys know, it is there. It's just not really worth it for the hassle. This should be the door that leads to our shortcut, which again, if you really want to get that item, get the cat ring from town, and just kind of fall off here to land on there, and then you have to aim for the middle bit. So we will... Up here is just straight cell. We've already done that. We don't really care. What you want to do is run across here to another new area, fight this guy. And we are still running out of stamina. Where the most important stat in this game is just your stamina. Get enough stamina, you can just spam all day long. Not enough stamina, you hit twice and you just run out of it. Item back there that we missed. Life gem, not the end of the world again. Fog gate is not to a boss, so don't worry about it. It's just leading into a next area. It's a bit of a higher area, we're just gonna be here to get the bonfire. And a couple of items, but here you go. Sinner's Rise is the area. You want to come up here, come up the ladder. We will try and get all the quick items here before we call this area wrapped for now. Bonfire right here. Light this quickly, there are enemies. This guy, this is where the archers were firing down at you. They've probably fallen down and gone below. We will go get a couple of items and wrap this area up for now. Like I said, we will be coming back here later on when we will be more leveled up and more level appropriate for it. Be careful not to fall off here. This guy is a bit annoying. There is an item right at the back. Human effigy, always useful. I'm gonna just use a life gem quickly, actually. In here is a bunch of archers again. They will switch to their flambers just to get close enough. Kill them off, pick up the items, and I believe that is all the items for us for now. So what we will do, the elevator here will bring us down to the actual Sinner's Rise area. Again, we are not leveled up enough for it just yet. We'll be coming back to this area later on. For now, we will continue on to our next actual area, which I believe will be Huntsman's Copse. So we want to go back to town to get to Huntsman's Copse. You want to come back to town, check quickly. As soon as she gets up, we might be able to get a level here. Yes, we can. Might go for Vit. Try and get our Vit up enough so that we can actually use that Ultra Greatsword. So to get to Huntsman's Copse, which, if I'm not mistaken, is going to be this way, but first I want to just go and double check how much that cat ring is. Cat ring, as I was mentioning earlier, is the ring that lets us take less fall damage. This, by the way, is a merchant. Don't kill her. She's a cat, but hey. She is the merchant that will show you your rank for every covenant you've discovered. She'll let you abandon whatever covenant you're in currently, but she also sells a bunch of rings. The Ring of the Evil Eye absorbs HP from defeated foes. Cat Ring is the one we're interested in here. It's 13,400, so we're missing about 10,000 souls. Lets you take a lot less fall damage. The Red Eye Ring, easier enemies will basically aggro to you. Name Engraved Ring, it's a must-have if you're playing with friends. It lets you co-op together much easier. And the Ring of Whispers, which we'll be coming back for later. Sorry. She also sells Prism Stone, some Lloyd Talismans, and some Alluring Skulls, and Homeward Bones. Actually, we've got a bunch of soul items, so it should be fine. So when you come down this way, again, this kind of looks like we're going to Haiti Tower Flames, but if you remember, the Miracle Vendor is right here. This shall... You can get her to move the path by giving her 2,000 souls. The other option, if you want, you can just kill her and she will drop the key to move the path. Basically, the contraption on the pillar here is just where the key goes, and it moves the paths. So, moving the path will get us more Rouge Water. Rouge Water is, where is it? Right over here. It restores HP and spell uses. Useful if you're a mage and you run out of herb, or you're just low on health and mana and you want to get both. The next area, Huntsman's Copse, is a lot of poison. More or less, but you want to... It's also the good area to farm to get anti-poison items. So you just want to follow this curved path all the way up. We might do one loop of this. You're gonna end up looping through this often, so we're gonna do one loop and then call it an episode.
I don't know who you frailty.
Here is another NPC. He won't talk to me because I don't have the faith and intelligence required. He is the dark sorcery vendor. Light a bonfire, we will rest here quickly. Probably didn't need to, but it's there, so we'll rest. An important tool to have for this area is going to be a bow and arrow or a crossbow, anything you need to aim manually. These guys are basically, won't attack you unless you attack them. I just kill them to get the items. Very weak enemies to kind of try and lure you in, I guess. Right here, you will notice, oh, that is there. The butterfly above there is what was throwing poison down. That green mist was poison. You want to use a bow and arrow, get him down. He dropped an item. We'll get that later. Guy with a torch over here. You want to use that as well. Again, not the toughest enemies. A lot of these guys won't even attack you. So like I said, this area, you end up looping back over yourself quite often. We're going to try and do one or two loops and then just call it an episode. I thought it was getting long enough. New enemy, bit of a bandit. In here, what you want to do to get the light in here is for the windows. Break the boards and you'll get a bit more light in here. You don't want to fall down there just yet for a very particular reason. We're going to be looping around and coming back anyway, so it's kind of counterproductive. You want to be careful. There is a bandit behind this door. They will cause poison. There are two bandits behind this door, apparently. That was very, very close, so we're going to go ahead and heal. That got us about half. I think it's about time we find another bone dust to get our Estus a little bit more usable. Guy hanging down there, so watch it. He'll come up as you go past him. Ladder to the next bonfire, but we're not going that way just yet. Around this corner is another enemy if you're playing the original version of Dark Souls 2. If not, he's a bit further back there. Again, another bandit. Dispatch him quickly and get the item that is here, cracked blue eye orb. Now what you want to do is, if you look down there is an item. You want to run off without jumping, which will let you land without rolling. You'll get a Ferris Lockstone and a Token of Fidelity. You can now drop down one more, and here it doesn't matter. I think you can just run it. I usually jump it just to be safe and land on this ledge here. This, again, is going to get us to loop around, nothing that way. You want to come in here, back into the cave system. You'll notice the poison is already going. So switch back to your bow, find that butterfly, and just take him out quickly. One fire arrow will do it, or two regular arrows, I believe. Run past here, get the item. He's just easier to kill from this way. Monastery Charm and a soul item. You'll notice he's right on the edge here. Hit him with, again, a fire arrow. Didn't actually mean to do that. I've got my arrows backwards. So now what you want to do is, to get to the bottom of this, is land on these mushrooms. You'll notice if you're playing the original version, down there is a executioner. If you're playing Scholars, you get a giant cursed frog. Hopefully he cannot curse me from up here. You can plunge attack him, I'm just gonna cheese him with a couple of arrows. And he can actually hit me with this curse fog up here, which is not good. If you get cursed, that's it for you, so we don't want to get cursed. We're going to have to keep an eye on that, and it's too late. Well then. Might edit that out. If not, there's another death. We died by curse. Actually, I think that was petrify, to be fair. Yeah, it's kind of an annoying way. You just insta-die. There's nothing you can do about it. Should have probably just jumped down and fought him, but... Oh wow, we took a massive dip to our health there, so we're just gonna use a human effigy quickly. Switch to our bow again, because again, everything respawns. Hit the butterfly twice with normal arrows. Seem to be running very low on arrows, so we might switch back to the crossbow. Again, we'll try and get the loop done here, so again, I might edit this, but if not, oh well. It's Dark Souls, you're gonna die. There's not much you can do about it. You're gonna end up dying at least a couple of times in the playthrough. This was 100% playthrough. I never said it was going to be perfect. So, again, we just want to go through here. Two guys are going to come up behind you. Watch out, don't fall down yet. If you fall down, it's not the end of the world, but we're going to be coming up on the other side, so instead of falling down, we're going to go around the whole way and just get life gem in here. I might actually go and get this bonfire to show you guys so that if we die again, it'll be much closer. Again, this is the way to actually progress. We're just trying to loop around and get all the secrets and items. So there you go, bonfire is lit. We should spawn back there if we die a second time. Not sure what this idiot is doing. Come on. So, going back up, we're gonna go do the jump again and go through the cave system again just to show you guys, again, 100% walkthrough playthrough of this. The enemy that was there fell down and fought us. We want to, again, just run off here. If you do roll, you can sort of try and control it, but usually you end up rolling too far. Go back through here. Switch to our bow and arrow again. Just got enough arrows to kill the two butterflies, so we don't get poisoned. And then I guess we'll switch to our crossbow and hope for the best to kill that cursed frog thing, who is very annoying. Don't think. Oh, we do have large bolts, so that might get us out of trouble here. So again, you want to fall on this top mushroom. Our souls are down there. We can see him. We'll just fire everything we have at him. I don't think he'll be able to curse us all the way up here, at least. Not sure why it takes so much stamina to fire a crossbow, but Dark Souls, what can you do? Oh, there is an actual other enemy down there, too. Try and get this guy as low as we can. And that's that. So we're going to wait for him to finish doing that, grab our souls, drop down, and kill him. Grab the large titanite that he drops, and then I kill this fool. Get a torch off of him. Get the poison moss off the butterflies we killed. Poison moss is what cures poison. Open the chest. To get Ricard's rapier. Fake wall back here. Large soul. Again, these are actually elevators. Come back up here. And we're almost done our loop here, so we'll just go through this again, another fake wall. Clear this area, and then we'll call it an episode. We did miss a couple of things in Lost Bastille. We'll probably end up going back. I think I need some more Pharos Lockstones to be able to do that. The stairs for this side are only on this side, so that's why I didn't want to fall up on top of the floor. Clear all these guys. You want to watch out not to fall into this pit here. We'll get the item in the back corner. You can light the torch in here. It just gives you a bit more light. I don't think it gives you any. Kill this guy because he's annoying me. Some other Estus. Actually, first Estus for this run, and then we will take the ladder up, which is our only option from this side. Now here there's a couple of ambushes and surprise attacks, so you want to go a little bit forward to just lure one of them. Got two of them. Kill them both. Pick up his items. Large rogue leggings. There's another enemy back there, which is an executioner. We'll just leave him be for now, because he doesn't seem to care that we're here. Poison moss and a life gem. And then you want to fall onto the ledge here, take a bit of fall damage, but you're back to the start, basically. We'll just run down here, go and use the bonfire, and actually, probably be faster to go back the other way. Get back to the bonfire, and we'll call this an episode. Not too much souls, but okay. Our 28 strength, which is what we were aiming for. Might get bit up to 17, which should let us carry a bit more. And yep, that will be this episode, so join us next time. We will continue through Huntsman's Copse. I'm not guaranteeing we'll do it in one episode, might be two more, but we'll get to the end of it, don't worry about it.